The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines calls on government to hear its side on why some of its projects were delayed. The grid operator asserts the delays do not mean it is being remiss in its responsibilities. The NGCP also highlights its initiatives to improve the transmission grid over the years. Some senators have warned the NGCP's franchise may be canceled if proven that it committed violations.
Meron hong delay sa ibang mga project, pero sana po tingnan rin nila yung naging performance over the past few years na hindi naman ho walang ginawa. In fact, napakarami ho na naiambag ng NGCP sa pagpapaganda at pagpapalawig ng transmission system. Sana po pakinggan kami kasi yun ho ang katotohanan. These are facts borne out by the records. Yes, meron kaming konting natisod na de-delay ng konti, pero hindi ho dahil ayaw naming gampanan o sadya naming iiwanan o tatanggihan yung obligasyon namin.
China weighs in on ownership concerns, hounding the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines, which is 40% owned by Chinese investors. China says it supports Chinese companies in carrying out practical cooperation in the Philippines in accordance with laws. It also called the Philippines a friendly and important partner. China's remark comes as President Marcos agreed to a comprehensive study on NGCP amid recent power interruptions in an alleged security breach. The Philippine government also vows to take back the entity if necessary. Prime Infra Chairman Enrique Razon hits back at a critic of the Malampaya contract extension. Razon points out former Philippine National Oil Company President Eduardo Manyalak is not in a position to push for the state's reacquisition of the gas project. That's as he claims Manyalak has a questionable history of attempting to compromise Philippine territory. Razon was referring to an agreement brokered by Manyalak for joint marine seismic undertaking with Vietnam and China in the West Philippine Sea. Manyalak has argued the Malampaya project may cause losses for government. Aside from Manyalak, environmental group Greenpeace is also opposed to the renewal of the contract.
Within this contract, aside from extending existing Malampaya exploration facility, it will have three exploration sites with an estimated of 5 billion each. No? But there's no guarantee that we will have an additional source of gas in this contract. So this is quite risky for the side of the government or even the contractors, no? Because there's no assurance that there will be an additional capacity from the existing facility, which has only around with an estimated 210 billion cubic feet of remaining deposit. So that means, based on the estimate of Department of Energy, it will last until probably around 2027. But there's another study that have shown that we only have around until next year in terms of the supply of Malampaya.
The Marcos administration looking to revive the Philippine Sugar Corporation to boost the commodity's production. That government-owned and controlled corporation was abolished in 2018 due to supposed overlapping functions with the Sugar Regulatory Administration. But after meeting with sugar industry stakeholders, Marcos believes farmers need the services of Philsucor. The agency was formed in 1983 to provide funding for the acquisition and rehabilitation of sugar mills.
It provides a, it is like a, it's financing for farmers, especially for cooperatives and farmers associations, yung mga tinatawag na block. Ngayon, hindi masyado silang nakakapagtrabaho dahil they tried to abolish the Philsucor in 2019, I think. Ngunit hindi na-abolish, nandiyan pa sila. Kaya't bubuhayin natin at babaguhin natin, titignan natin kung ano yung mga pagbabago para makapag-adjust tayo dito sa sitwasyon natin ngayon.
Marcos, the concurrent agriculture secretary, also bared more details about government's planned importation of 150,000 metric tons of sugar.
We agreed on an importation schedule and how we will open up the importation to all of the traders. In the end, we will still continue to to favor in terms of buying local production over importation.
The Philippine General Hospital says it's seeing an increase in COVID admissions. PGH spokesperson Dr. Jonas De Rosario says they now have 60 patients in their COVID ward from just 10 last month. De Rosario says most are considered incidental COVID cases or those who went to the PGH initially for other purposes. He adds, while those confined have only mild infection, they may be forced to open up more space soon to accommodate other patients.
For the last 5 days po, medyo consistent. Kaya nga po, pero ngayon po ay parang sa tumataas na bilang, mapipilitan po kami na magdagdag po ng ilang beds o kwarto para sa mga COVID patients kinakailangan.
On to another commodity supply concern. The Philippine Agriculture Department to seek clarification on the real situation of onion supply in the country. This amid warnings of a possible shortage this year. Senior Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban says there have been no orders for any onion importation in the last 4 months.
Hindi natin malamang kung anong totoo. Marami nagsasabi, maraming onion sa Pilipinas. Marami rin naman nagsasabi, walang onion sa Pilipinas. Ang sa aming sinasabi, titingnan natin kung talagang walang onion sa Pilipinas.
In a House probe, Bureau of Plant Industry Director Glenn said, government is considering importing 8,000 metric tons of white onions this year. Some money lost in the recent unauthorized fund transfers that hit GCash accounts remain unrecovered. Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla says GCash shouldered some of the funds stolen by fraudsters. But he noted all affected users already had their balances corrected.
Malaking bahagi ng nanakaw eh hindi na itakbo. Since in advance na ng GCash yung bayad sa... In other words, na-restore yung mga nawalan. Even though the deposit where the money went, of course, could not cover all of it because nailabas na yung iba. Kaya effectively, GCash is shouldering the difference.
A report claims the intelligence quotient or IQ of Filipinos is below average. But experts say this does not equate to a lack of intelligence. More from Rafael Bosano.
Below average, this is the intelligent quotient score of the Philippines according to the World Population Review. In a list of almost 200 countries, the country ranked 111 after getting an IQ score of 81.64. An IQ score of 100 is considered average. Among the top 10 countries and territories with the highest average IQ, Japan holds the top spot, followed by Taiwan, Singapore, Hong Kong, and China. Looking further at the list, only 12 countries reach scores of 100 and above. But this doesn't mean that the rest of the world lacks intelligence.
Whenever we try to measure yung IQ ng isang tao, hindi lang siya nakafocus doon sa kumbaga average kasi meron din siyang iba't ibang klase. Di ba? We call it multiple intelligence. Ang important naman is that hindi naman fixed yung IQ ng isang tao. Na actually, nai-increase pa natin ito depending on the stimulations that we do for our brains.
Some Filipino parents are not surprised by the ranking.
Halos po kasi lahat ngayon, tutok yung mga bata sa gadget. Yun po siguro yung cause po kaya bumababa yung IQ ng mga bata. Kung ano-ano sigurong pinapanood, like parang yung ibang bata po na humaling sa laro na ML.
Kalipaga explains there's a phenomenon called digital dementia where the excessive use of gadgets and technology affects one's intellectual capacity. Kalipaga adds an individual's IQ is determined by a multitude of factors including genetics, home environment, and overall nutrition. This is why the Department of Health says a child's nutrition is important.
Nasa womb pa lang o buntis pa lang ang nanay, naalagaan na po natin ang ating mga kabataan ng mga kailangan nilang nutrisyon para po sila ilumaki na mataas ang quotient for intelligence and also healthy. Kukumpletohin natin lahat ng kailangan nila, pati na rin titignan natin yung mga nakakaapekto na sa kanilang kalusugan.
There are also many ways to improve one's IQ. These include reading books, exposing kids to various sensory and learning materials, including playing puzzles, which stimulate cognition. This isn't the first time the Philippines ranked below average. In 2019, the country was at the bottom in reading comprehension. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has signed into law a measure that amends the fixed terms of ranking officials of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Under the new law, only the AFP Chief of Staff will have a maximum tour of duty of 3 years, unless sooner terminated by the President. 2 years is given for the Chiefs of the Philippine Army, Philippine Air Force, and Philippine Navy, as well as the Superintendent of the Philippine Military Academy. The mandatory retirement for enlisted military personnel is also adjusted to 57 years old. Those with the rank of Brigadier General and Commodore will have a maximum tenure in grade of 5 years, while those with the rank of Colonel or Captain will have 10 years. The amendments come amid reports of grumblings in the military over the earlier version of the fixed-term law. Persecution and not prosecution. That's how the camp of suspended lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. called the filing of murder complaints against him over the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. His lawyer Ferdinand Topacio adds a possible arrest warrant won't force Teves to return to the Philippines, citing his right to self-preservation. Teves has been overseas since March, refusing to come home due to what he called serious threats to his life.
But your intention is not to evade the processes of the court, but to secure yourself. Self-defense is a recognized right. The right to keep oneself out of danger is a recognized right even by the Constitution and the Supreme Court. Paano kami makaka-assure ng fairness kung ngayon pa lang yung mismong hepe at yung boss ng mga mag-determine kung may probable cause, sinasabi ng siya ang mastermind, malakas ang ebidensya. Those are the cards that we have been dealt with at talagang tagilid kami dahil bias ang Secretary of Justice.
As for the widow of Governor Degamo, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo believes they have a solid case against Teves. She also vows to continue pushing for Teves's expulsion from Congress after a House panel rejected her request, citing lack of form and content.
We might explore another avenue to have him expelled, like the angle on gambling. I think the reason why Congressman Arnie wouldn't confirm nor deny whether or not he seek asylum in another country was because for fear that it might really be the reason that he will be expelled. So I will be very happy if Congress will pursue that. And not just me, along with me are hundreds and maybe thousands others from Negros Oriental who would love to see him expelled from work.